In this video, we want to focus on a complex of proteins referred to as a costamere. And we want to focus on how those are important to linking force generation within sarcomeres end-to-end within myofibrils to the extracellular matrix and onward to the tendon. So in our picture down here, what we have is we have a cell membrane here, right? We have extracellular matrix proteins, which would surround that cell membrane, right? If you recall previous video, individual cells are wrapped by connective tissue layer, and then the fascicles are wrapped by connective tissue layer, and then whole muscles are wrapped by connective tissue layer, sort of these concentric layers of connective tissues around the individual structures. Now, inside the cell, we have myofibrils. Now, we're not showing nuclei and mitochondria and other organelles. We're sort of focusing on just the myofibrils here. And when we look at those, we can see that we go from Z-disc to Z-disc, right? That would be an individual sarcomere. But then, of course, we have sarcomere after sarcomere after sarcomere lined up, thousands of them in a row in each myofibril. And again, where they overlap, right, where we have this overlap between the thick and thin filaments in the zone of overlap is where we would generate tension, pulling the Z-discs closer together, right? We would generate, every time we contract, we would pull these Z-discs closer together. The same thing would happen in this particular sarcomere, right? And you see that we would get overall shortening there. Well, how do we transmit that force generation to tendons and bones? What we have is the Z-disc proteins are actually linked to via protein filaments to one another. In other words, the myofibrils are sort of suspended within a complex web of protein fibers. And those protein fibers are linked to, at the membrane, that series of proteins called the costamere. So what the costamere is going to do is actually help convey this shortening, and I'll draw it here as well, the shortening that we experience here, right, outside, across the membrane, to the outside of the cell, to the extracellular structures. Now, the costamere spans the membrane, and then via some other proteins will link to this extracellular matrix. So that force internally would be conveyed to the external structures as well, right? Causing pulling between these different regions of the extracellular connective tissue, essentially shortening it, right? And so that pulling on the extracellular matrix will then be conveyed all the way to the end, you know, of the cell fiber, to the tendons and then onwards to the bones, generating the force required for skeletal movement.